Hey guys, welcome back to my channel Asterix Solution. This video we are going to start with the concept of servlet. Now before moving into the concept of servlet, you need to understand what is the difference between a static page and a dynamic page. Obviously, all the major websites you are using these days, for example Facebook, Instagram, not a website but an app, LinkedIn, these all are dynamic websites. The pages are not built up like once and are given to you and you see the same pages again and again. Every time someone is doing someplace, you get notified. Now when you get notified, that means that the data is being updated someplace. That place is in the dynamicism. Now what usually happens when you click on or you go on a normal website, let's say which is not a dynamic website, which is a static website. For example, let's say you hit something www.xyz.com, your request go, and when you hit for xyz.com, by rule, it tries to search for index.html. Now the request goes. So from your browser, a request is being sent to your server. Server checks whether it has index.html. If found, what happens? So that was your request actually going from your server, your browser to your server. And at the server, it checks, okay, do I have index.html? If yes, what happens next is it put the content of your index.html into a response packet, send it to your browser then displays it on itself. Like we have our body and we are putting on, like this shirt is rendered on me. Same way on your response browser, the HTML code is being rendered. So basic HTML page, that's how a normal static website work. But these days, that's not going to help you out. You need dynamic. Everything you write has to be stored. That cannot be done with your web server. So to bring in that nature, you need what? First thing first, let's try understand what a web server can do for you. A basic Apache HTTP web server can store the static pages for you, and it can store, basically give you JavaScript and it can show you the current time. But you want security, you want database management, you want lifecycle management, that cannot be done. Very clear, that cannot be done and you need that. So to fulfill your need, you need a container. A container is like your friendly helper app. Now just imagine how it works. Usually when you get into some trouble, you try to solve it yourself. That's how a web server works. When a request arrives, it tries to check that, can I handle this request? Yes, if I can handle this request, send the response back. But what if I cannot handle the request? So what do you do? Before taking it to the family, you take it to the friends first. Okay, can someone of you handle this for me? If yes, you revert them back. So container is like a friendly helper app to your web server, which can do following certain things for you. So you use the Apache web server and you use Tomcat as a container. So the Tomcat here is your friend. He is being helping you out for putting up the stuff that your normal Apache server cannot do, like database management, securities, lifecycle management, session management. There are a lot of stuff your container will do for you. So servlets are placed inside your container because an Apache HTTP server cannot handle your HTML request. So for all the dynamic requests, the call has to go to your container, which is your Tomcat in this scenario. Now, if we can go back to the definition, servlet are discrete Java classes, which resides into not inside the web server, but inside the container of the web server. So you can see in the diagram right now that servlet is not placed inside the server, it is placed inside the container of the web server, where server accepts the request, process the data, respond back to the client, and it is not going to happen like using some main method. So when I say component architecture, it's not going to happen with the main methods that you go on command prompt, say Java space my servlet, and it's going to start running. No, it's a container managed system. It will be taken care by the container. You need to know how to configure your Apache Tomcat. You need to know where to keep your servlet, and then you need to know how to work on it. So this series, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you both the ways, how to download a normal Apache Tomcat and configure it in your machine, and also how to run it on Eclipse. So servlet, as per the definition, are discrete Java classes which resides into the container of a web server. As I have told you that you need to understand how it works, that all the dynamic requests will be taken care by Tomcat and not by Apache, but the combination of both on which our servlet works is Apache Tomcat. So this was just the basic stuff about servlet. Servlets are purely Java codes which are written, and we'll try understand more about it in the next video. Do subscribe to the channel and watch for more videos in this series. Thank you for watching this video.